Kathy Davini.
And I'm Lucy Reimer.
I don't think so.
What? That doesn't count?
We're so excited.
You're watching the Bradley Beat. Are we supposed to say that?
Yes.
What else do we say? Three, so you were ready. You should have known I was going to either say Lucy or Jermaine.
We're so excited to have Rob Alderman with us today. He is one of our favorite friends of the show, and he's going to be filling in this week and next week for Lucy Reimer.
Absolutely.
Who couldn't?
I'm here in your moment of need, Bradley Beat. Remember, you know who wasn't here? Jermaine.
Jermaine wasn't here.
Or Tim Poteet.
He's on the road, and Tim's on a cruise.
What?
Tim had a birthday on Wednesday.
So I have a follow-up from the Tim Poteet episode.
Let's hear it.
Is that I saw Tim Poteet right after that episode aired, because we did Spirits, Legends, and Lore together, and he still didn't tell me why he was famous. Every time he got near me, he just shook his head and laughed a lot. And he said, my wife thought that was so funny. I was like, why, Poteet? You're so famous. What did you do? But he wouldn't tell me. So it still remains a secret.
It's
still a secret.
He's on a cruise.
Okay. Well, I hope you're loving it, Poteet. So what do we got going on the show today?
So we have Jennifer Pennell-Aslinger that's going to come and join us eventually with Junior Achievement.
Yep.
She does a lot of great work with kids from kindergarten through high school and above and Junior Achievement.
It's a great organization.
It is a great
Doing great things. What else do you want to talk about?
I want to talk about what's going on with you and your band.
Oh, okay. Well, we've got a New Year's Eve show.
You do?
Yeah, we'll be playing New Year's Eve at Pokey's with Dennis Purvis. His band is like the Pokey band. They're like the Tim Poteet of Pokey's.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, oh yeah. So Dennis has a band called the Hush Honey.
Hush Honey.
He said it's an inside joke. I don't get it. For a long time, several shows, I accidentally called them the Hush Money. Because I thought it was like a political statement. And he was like, it's the hush, honey. So I think it might be like when your wife is like, hush, honey. Like when she's telling you to hush. I don't really know. Dennis, maybe you could tell me. Tim Poteet, maybe you could figure it out. But anyway, we are going to be playing a show at Pokey's. It starts at 9 and goes till 1 a.m. because it's a New Year's Eve show.
And so how much is it to get in?
It's $10 to get in. Totally
Very
worth it,
reasonable.
Though. It's a lot of rock and roll that night. It'll be a lot of fun. And then... honestly, from a music perspective, we're trying to wrap our heads around it. I'm in every way for the Alderman group, for what's happening in Cleveland, for the band, all those sort of things. I'm in the like plan 2023, wrap my head around it, because we've just been go, and you know, we'll make a new record in the new year. We're gonna release one probably sometime in January that's already done. I just didn't want to try to release it at Christmas because it was just too much of a on top of everything else. So we'll release a new record early next year, and we'll record a new record. But other than that, I don't really...
Is this going to be dancing music for New Year's Eve?
I would say you could kind of dance to what Dennis plays, to the Hush Honey. They play like a lot of fun cover songs that people will know. They do everything from, you know, Billy Joel to, you know, like, I don't know.
Well,
like
that's fun.
Harder rock stuff that people like, Joe Seeger. Like, they do a lot. They're very, very talented. We will be that brand of... original music that people don't dance to and probably don't like as much.
Well, it'll all be fun.
You came and saw us? What'd you think? Be honest. I'm ready.
I always have a good time when I'm with you, Rob.
It was a good time. But did you like the music?
Yes,
even though you didn't know them, right? You don't know the songs because they're not on the radio.
The song if it's got a beat.
That was a fun show.
That
was a good night. So anyway, we'll do more of that. We're going to, you know... We play a couple times a month. That's what we're going to do in 2023.
Well, you'll have to keep us updated on that so we can talk about it. Other things going on for New Year's Eve. I know the Elks Lodge has something going on for New Year's Eve. CASA has their New Year's Eve party at the museum, which they still had a few tickets left if you want to do that and support CASA or the Elks Lodge or the really famous Rob Alderman.
You know what? Yeah, I won't stop you from coming to Pokey's. If you haven't been to Pokies, you should go. Like,
I haven't been in a long time.
Pokies is its own vibe. It's like its own. It's like the most Cleveland of Cleveland. You know, I say that like in a good way. Like, I, you know, last time I was there, the last time I played Pokies, I got done playing, and I was packing up my stuff, and this absolutely giant, ripped muscle man. I don't know if he was a professional bodybuilder or a police officer or like a fireman. He's like giant. He's tall or big. And he stopped. He stepped out right in front of me. And I thought, uh-oh, like, what have I done? Because he's looking right at me. And then, this is a true story, he hugged me and he said, I love what we're doing with what's happening in Cleveland, man.
Oh,
and he just started
what
hugging
a relief.
Me. And I was like, yeah, I was like, oh, thank goodness. And he's like, I didn't know you had a band. And he was like crying and happy. And his wife was patting his shoulder. She's like, he loves it. He loves it. So it's like, I was like, that's Pokies, like where the, like, the biggest scary man gives you a big hug. And
I think that's awesome.
Yeah, it was cool. It was, yeah, it was really cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was a lot. What are you going to do for New Year's?
I haven't decided yet. So we've got a couple of things that we're choosing from, but I haven't made that decision yet.
Are we gonna?
So now that I know about what you're doing, I might.
Maybe
have
you'll
to
come
go
out.
By there.
Maybe you should. You should come by. It'll be a good time. I really do. I think it'll be a fun time. So, are we allowed to talk about your thing for the library yet, or do we have to wait?
We'll probably wait a little bit.
Because every
on
time
that.
I see you, that's what I think now. You know, there's
we're
a,
always, we
people don't know
something.
That you have something up your sleeve that's coming in the new year.
We'll have
to talk about it. When you're going to talk about it, invite me on the show.
I will.
I'll come be on that show.
We'll talk about that.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to think what else we have going on. So we've got Christmas this weekend.
Yeah.
So what do you have going on with your family?
Well, just quiet. We like to settle ourselves for Christmas.
It's
so,
a great day to do that.
We have a Christmas tradition that goes back many, many, many years where my brother and his family and then me and my family get together at my mom's house, and she throws a little Christmas party, and she makes barbecue ribs. She makes
nice
baby back ribs. And so we have the Christmas ribs, and we just spend some time together and exchange gifts and just enjoy our time together. And so I love that. That happens. So Christmas Eve is more of the excitement, and then Christmas morning's pretty quiet. You know, we get up, we have some coffee. Ashley's a baker, so she bakes delicious treats.
That sounds great.
And we eat the treats, and we open gifts, and I just kind of take it quiet.
So what are you hoping to get? Do you have anything?
No.
I never have anything that I'm hoping to get.
You
just
know,
being together is the best gift for me.
To be honest, whatever I'm given is always lovely, but like the gift is that things slow down for a minute. That's actually the gift.
And be together.
Because even like the holiday season, like between Thanksgiving and now, is so fast. Everything's fast. It's nice that on that day you can just slow down, take it easy. That's my favorite gift.
Well, I'm very excited. My daughter and her fiancé are going to be spending the night with puppies, which are like having grandchildren.
Okay, what kind of puppies? What do they have?
So she rescued a coon hound that's adorable, and he's just growing so fast.
Great.
And the fiancé was not on board with her getting this coon hound.
So
she said, okay, you just get any dog you want.
Okay.
So she drove 2 hours to rescue this dog, and he's adorable. His name is Barley.
All right, love him.
So the
I like a coon hound. I like coon hounds.
He's so fun.
Now they do howl. I had a coon hound, and when they learn she may change her tune when he finds his voice. Like, he's little now.
He's found his voice on occasion.
Goodness, it is like a fire
sounds
engine.
Sounds like a screaming baby.
It's just terrifying of her. So she, instead of getting rid of the dog, she told him he could get a dog.
Right. And guess
that's
what
a
he
good
got?
Move. What'd he get?
A Great Dane. Baby Great Dane.
Oh, so they're going to have both. They're going to have loud and big. They're going to have one dog that's really loud and one dog. You know, I had a Great Dane, and I'll say this. Wonderful dogs.
Yes.
They are absolutely, the temperament on a Great Dane is
oh my
is
gosh,
wonderful.
He's slow-mo in everything he does.
Yeah, I like a Great Dane.
Big, long legs, and he'll
What's
play
his name?
For a
What's
minute.
What's his name?
Bruce.
So they have Bruce and Barley.
Bruce and Barley.
Well, and that sounds like it's going to be a fun time.
Oh, they're a joy. They bring them over. They try and bring them over every week to be part of the pack with my three dogs.
Okay, that's good.
Yes, because they're going to outgrow them really quickly.
Sure. What do you have?
Dachshunds.
Oh, of course you do. Why didn't I know that? I should have, like, when I... Of course you do. That just makes sense.
My cup at Mash and Hops has a dachshund.
They're so adorable and yet so mean.
They're not mean. These are long-haired dachshunds. Okay. You're thinking of wire hair. They're a little snippy.
Yeah, they are.
But the long hair are
okay,
not.
They're not. I didn't know that. Well, you know, we're terrier family now. I always had big dogs because I'm a huge man. And I'm always in, like, I'll break anything that I touch. That's how I feel in life. So I always had really big dogs. And now we have three terriers. We have two Boston Terriers and one rat terrier.
They're not that big.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. They're not. These are the first small dogs I've ever had.
Oh.
And we have them all dressed in bow ties. So they literally...
They're good-looking they're wearing, dogs.
They're wonderful dogs. And they're sweet, and they're a lot of fun. They're a little wild sometimes. But, you know, but I thought, this is like a funny thing, like these three little tiny dogs running through our house with their bow ties.
Now, what are their names?
Bruiser.
Sure.
Boyd and Max.
Nice.
And Max was, we didn't name Max. Max was a rescue that someone, after I got Boyd, Boyd became like Cleveland famous. He was like on social media. Everywhere.
Okay.
And after we got him, then I got tagged. Ashlyn Morlock, I think, tagged me in a post. Someone in Knoxville had an old Boston and they were looking for a home.
Aww.
And so I said, well, sure, I'll meet him. And the guy drove down from Knoxville, and he like brought his kennel and his he didn't just bring the dog
for me,
he was gonna leave the dog. And so my daughter didn't want him at first. She just wasn't in the mood to meet a new dog. As soon as she met him, she scooped him up and took him into Ashley and was like, Mom, this is my literal baby, can we keep it? And like, what are you gonna say then? And she treats him like that. She reads him stories at night. This is the most spoiled rescue in all of history.
That's great.
She's down there like, I'm sorry you had a bad day, Max. I'll read you two stories tonight. I'm like,
I love
give me
that.
A break. So like
that's
his
great.
Yeah, that's his life. And then Boyd is my work dog. You know, he comes with me to work. So
I love that. There's nothing better in life than dogs.
I agree. Dogs are wonderful.
Well, you know, I've been trying to open a private dog park.
Did you know that?
No,
I didn't know that.
We'll have to talk about this.
What?
Yes, but before we get any deeper into dog conversation, let's bring on Jennifer to learn about Junior Achievement.
Let's do it. Jennifer with Junior Achievement after this.
We'll be right back. And we're back with Jennifer Pennell-Aslinger with Junior Achievement.
Yes, thank you for having us today.
You guys have a lot going on. You've been with the organization a long, long time.
Yes.
So tell us what Junior Achievement is for those that don't know.
Yeah. So we are a nonprofit organization. We work inside the school systems in Bradley, McMinn, Meigs, Monroe, and Polk counties.
Wow.
So we have five counties that we actually cover. And we go in and teach children financial literacy, workforce readiness, and entrepreneurial skills.
Great.
So what are these juniors achieving?
So they are achieving being citizens of the world.
It's a lofty goal.
A lofty goal.
It's a lofty goal.
Yes.
I don't know that. Listen, pause. Everyone, listen. It sounds like many adults I know need to sign up for Junior Achievement. So if you could please see her after the show, get signed up for your Become a Citizen of the World class.
Yeah.
Okay, continue.
So we teach them not only how to get and keep a job. So as we know, these students sometimes are having a hard time communicating,
sure.
collaborating, mm-hmm. critical thinking is major right now. So we give them all those skills.
That's awesome.
Then, once they get a job, they don't know what to do with the money. So we teach them all the financial literacy skills.
That's great.
So what are you supposed to do with that paycheck? Well, you take it to the bank. You know, deposit it, you're going to have a debit card, how to use that debit card responsibly, what's credit, why do we need credit, what happens if you don't have a good credit score,
mm-hmm.
How can you mess it up when you're 18, 19 mm-hmm. years mm-hmm. old, and then it hurts you later in life when
30,
you go to apply
40
for a loan.
Years old?
Yep.
Yeah, sure.
And then the last thing is the entrepreneurship. So we have a lot of students that have a lot of fantastic ideas. start your own business. Stay right here in your community in the Ocoee region and employ your friends.
That sounds awesome.
That is awesome. So tell me, how many kids do you have involved in the program regularly?
Yep. So we go kindergarten all the way up through their senior year, and we have about 5,000 students a year.
That's amazing.
Is this like a an opt-in during school, like during the school day?
Yes. So during the school day, how it works, the teachers invite us in. Administration approves us to come in. We hook up with a local community member, so you all, and say, hey, would you like to come in and talk to a great bunch of children? So we give you a kit that's got games, interactive activities inside of it, so the kids are learning without realizing they're learning. And then you go into the school system and you present the program.
So does it happen like they call like a big assembly and you do it? Or is it like this was is
individual
when it would be like, oh, so it's like we stop learning this thing to learn this thing for a second.
But the great thing is our program covers their state standards.
Oh, that's fantastic.
So, for instance, in kindergarten, you're working on the reading skills. Well, our activities, reading skills.
Okay, that's great.
So in addition to teaching them how to be great citizens and be productive members of society, we're also teaching those math skills, reading skills, collaboration skills. So we take into account what the teachers are going to have to teach, and we say this is just, we're adding another layer to it.
Okay.
So how often do you go in?
Okay, so elementary school programs is 5 visits. Sometimes we do those
a year.
Yes, a year. So same group of kids. So you'll go in and meet with them 5 times, 30 to 45 minutes, depending on their age grade. Like kindergarten, 30 minutes is all you're going to hold their attention. Our older kids, 45 minutes. And then high school is an hour that we spend with them. Now, we don't lecture to them for an hour or 45 minutes. We talk to them 5 or 10 minutes about what we're going to talk to that day about that day. And then we play these games and activities.
And that's for each class?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. So each grade
level.
That
takes a lot of people.
It takes a lot of people. So we have about 250 businesses or community members that we work with a year to put these programs on.
That's massive.
That's massive.
How long have you been doing this?
We have been in Cleveland since 1965.
1965.
But still a lot of people don't know about us. Junior Achievement itself, so Junior Achievement, JAUSA, who develops our curriculum every year, has been around since 1919. So over 100 years.
Did you know that?
I knew it. We moved here from Mississippi, and it was very big where we lived, but they didn't come into the school. You went as a group to... They had a building, a center, and then they broke you up into smaller groups, and that's where they provided you with some kind of, whether it's a service or a product to sell, and you had to figure out how much should that product be, how much, where are we going to sell it, you know, how are we going to advertise it?
Yep. So that's the JA Company program. That's what that program is called, and that is where the students own and operate a business for 13 weeks.
Yes.
So they come up with the product, they're the sales team, they're the marketing team, they're the management team. The volunteer is strictly there to say, have you thought about this? Or maybe we should rethink that a little bit.
Or this is a great idea, let me buy out your business and then start it myself.
Yes, exactly, exactly.
I think you and I should go into the school systems and figure out which of these kids have a good idea before they know it's good.
Before
they realize it. And then we could own so many little businesses.
It's
a thought. It's just a thought. This is my new business model. My new business model is based off of Junior Achievement doing well. So everyone, I need you to give the Junior Achievement so that we can have business. Kathy and I can have businesses that we purchase.
I need children. To do something.
Sounds like Scrooge.
Yeah.
I buy this from the children.
We're taking their idea away. So we have one going right now at the Boys and Girls Club. They are creating these amazing business cards. It's a digital business card. Never run out of business cards again. All of your information, of course, I'm not very techie, so All of your information is stored on this digital business card. Mm-hmm. You tap someone's phone, they get all your contact information.
I've had that done
yes.
before.
So the Boys and Girls Club, those kids have come up with this product. They're selling the product right now, actually out of the Pie Center. So they're selling this product.
You managed to get the Pie Center in here an extra time. You're in this book. Well done, Junior Achievement.
We love the Pie Center.
Well done. So. It's like the Jermaine Purifoy of organizations in our town. It's just everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm like, I was getting my lemonade on my way in here, and I was like, thank you for my lemonade. And they were like, have you considered the Pie Center? I was like, what? I was just trying to get my lemonade. Anyway, whatever. This isn't about you, Pie Center. This is about Junior Achievement. Well, okay, so I need to, I'm a board member of the Boys and Girls Club. That's a true story. I'm a board member. Did you know that?
It's a very
powerful position.
So Shannon.
And I'm going to go tell them I need my digital business
yes.
card.
So Shannon is our volunteer.
Yeah, okay.
So Shannon Skipper is our volunteer over there, so he can tell you all about it.
All right, I'm ready. I'm going to purchase this from the children.
And then it sounds like you need to come and volunteer with us as well.
That's so what you it can does. You would think ideas. That would be true. You would think I should. And then, but you haven't actually turned me loose in front of a group of children yet. So you slow down. I would slow down just a little.
Maybe high schoolers.
Maybe.
So
maybe.
So what other things are you guys doing? I know you've got to raise money to help support this programming, and I know that there's a race coming up
yes.
in 23. What else do you guys have on your schedule?
Yeah, so we do two fundraisers a year. In March, so spring of every year, we do a huge bowl-a-thon. So Bowl for Education.
And where is that?
That's at Classic Lanes here, Classic Lanes in Athens, and okay. then Leisure Time in Cleveland. So we
nice.
Do two different dates because we do cover five areas. So two different dates. You pay $150 registration fee. That's your team of five, that's your game, that's your shoe rentals, and some great door prizes that you'll receive. So that brings in money. We also in August do a 5K fun run or walk. So if you don't want to run, like me, I don't run, you can do the 1 mile walk. So those two fundraisers every year, in addition to some sponsorships, we receive through our annual campaign.
I could probably walk a mile.
Yeah. You can.
Do you think?
Come
yeah.
out. I mean, Tinsley, it's at Tinsley Park.
It's close. It's a close one.
Yep. Fun, Saturday morning.
Okay.
You're through by 9:30, okay. and then you can go over
so
and get your
what
Chick-fil-A.
Do you do as part of the fun run? Do you just show up or walk? You just show
yep.
up and
you
walk?
Can, you can pre-register with Junior Achievement. So ocoeeregion.ja.org is our website. Mm-hmm. For the bowl-a-thon, you sign your team up. You get a team of five together. You pay your $150 fee. You come and bowl that night. Have
and
a
it's
great
$150 for five.
For five.
Yeah.
Yep.
So
yep.
when
$150
you hear
for five.
That, you know, it's really not
yes.
that big of a price when you divide it.
And
when is that one? When does that one
that
happen?
That one is March the 23rd in Cleveland and the March 30th in Athens.
We think we should make a Bradley Beat team.
Oh, we could make
that
a
would
Bradley
be awesome.
Beat team. Except people
we could get,
behind
listen,
us
we
have
could
these
get,
yeah. in the same
we
space.
We could get like bowling shirts.
Let's do that.
Bradley yeah. Beat bowling
Let's
shirts.
Let's do that.
Yep.
We need to do
this
that.
This year's theme is back to the 80s.
Okay.
So when you're designing your shirt,
okay.
you
yeah, okay.
do a back to the 80s costume.
Yes.
So we'll have people dress up that
okay.
night. But all of these fundraisers allow us to go into the school systems mm-hmm. free of charge. I mean, we all know the schools are already taxed. They mm-hmm. can't pay for anything else. So it allows us to bring all this wonderful information into the schools free of charge for them. And get this knowledge out to all these students.
Tell us some of your success stories with your students that have actually gone through the program and continued with what they have planned.
Yeah. So probably my most recent is Jake. He's going to be working for State Farm. So yes, he's going to be Jake with State Farm.
My current insurance guy is already Jake from
is it
State
Jake
Farm.
Duos?
Yes.
So Jake Duos.
Jake Duos. Listen, Jake, there's another Jake coming for you.
Yes.
I'm sorry, well, buddy.
The good thing is Jake Duos already knows my Jake.
Okay.
Because he was his intern.
Oh, nice.
So
this is out of control.
Yeah. So small world.
I don't know what we're going to have two Jakes from State Farm right here.
Yeah.
You heard it here first on the Bradley Beat, everyone.
Yeah. So Jake went through the JA Company program, so the program you were speaking about earlier.
Right.
He decided, you know what? I'm going to do this business thing. I'm going to start my own business. So through Job Shadow, went out, saw Jake Duos from State Farm, did a great job for Jake. Jake said, hey, if you ever want to intern, you just let me know. So Jake, our Jake, started interning with him, fell in love with it, was like, this is what I'm going to do for the rest of my life.
Wow.
Went through the program. He is slated now to become the youngest State Farm agent.
Great.
Ever.
Good for him.
Wow.
So he is going to open his own business. We're not sure exactly where it's going to be yet, you know, because we already have a Jake with State Farm here in Cleveland.
You should open it right next to Jake's office. So. Jake, if you're watching this, rent this kid, rent baby Jake some space next to you.
And you'll have
What's
two
funny
Jakes.
Is Big Jake is already not that giant. He is my right. So like, it's gonna be hard to call other Jake baby Jake. He might be taller than Jake.
Yeah.
This is getting very confusing. I don't know.
Yeah.
Junior achievement is definitely giving us a lot to think about.
Yeah.
In the world. Well, good for you, baby Jake. I hope you see this. We wish you nothing but the most success, and I hope you do so well that you make Big Jake question if he should have given you the internship.
If he should have interned you. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And so, then all the time we have students that'll come up to us. Like, I was in McMahon County the other day, and a student came up and said, hey, I just wanted to let you know me and my mom are doing that budgeting thing y'all told us about.
Oh, good.
Oh, that's awesome.
So not only are we getting the next generation, but we're kind of, the material that we send home, some of the parents are looking at and saying,
great.
Hey, I've never done a budget before. How does that, because our budgets are really easy, 10% for this, 20% for this. So they can sit down and say, this is how much I should be paying for housing. This is how much I should be paying for an automobile. Mm. So, you know, we get those stories all the time. Our volunteers run into these kids again because we try to get volunteers from their community so that they will see them again. And they can start that all-important networking early. You know, how often are we looking for people to network with?
Jennifer, I wanted you to tell us if people listening or watching wanted to get involved, what kind of a commitment would that be and how would they find their way into involvement?
So the great thing is, all you've got to tell me is that you want to do something with Junior Achievement and I will find you something to do. We have as little as a 30-minute commitment to an all-day commitment. So you can tell me, hey, I'm available on Tuesdays for 45 minutes at 11 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And we'll match you with an 11 o'clock class that you can be in for 45 minutes.
And people that work can still get involved?
Yes. And oftentimes your company wants you to be out in the community. Do it. Score two, you know, kill two birds with one stone. Fulfill your company's commitment to volunteer in the community and help out a great organization.
Now, do you guys have an office in town?
Yes. So we are located on Cleveland State's campus, so where they've built that new,
nice,
beautiful nursing building.
Yep.
We're that little small brick building that's right across the street from the main campus. Also, our website, so ocoeeregion.ja.org.
Okay.
You can check that out. It'll have our events. It'll have ways to volunteer. And, you know, you can always write a check. We need money coming in to pay for these.
You wouldn't be opposed to it.
I wouldn't be opposed to it.
You would take the check.
I mean, I will actually come to your business and pick it up.
Many of you think that the nonprofits don't want your money, but that's actually untrue.
That's totally untrue.
You really do actually want their money. Listen, give this thing's good. Give to it. If you're watching this, tell them, Kathy, tell them give.
Please give money to all of the nonprofits, and today especially to Junior Achievement.
That's right. It's Junior Achievement Day. That's right.
As they're planning their future new year.
Yeah. And if you can't write a check, come volunteer. Also, you know, we have donors that say, hey, I can give you a couple reams of paper.
Mm. That
a
helps.
Couple of reams of paper I don't have to purchase,
right,
is more money I can pour into my kids.
That's right.
So nothing is too small. Nothing is too large either. But nothing's too small. Every little bit helps your students.
That's awesome.
Thank you so much for
coming on.
We are about out of time today, but I would love for you to come back and give us an update on what's going on, and especially when you have events going on that we can get involved in.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be great. Rob and I are going to be practicing our bowling.
We're going to be ready. And baby Jake, we've got our eye on you. Baby Jake, we expect big things.
You guys have a great day. Thanks for being with us on the Bradley Beat, and we'll see you next time.
Yeah.